Welcome back, Tigers. It is hard to believe that Salesforce does not have a way to change multiple account owners at once from the front end of Salesforce. They provide a way in Setup, but we would have to give our users access to Setup, which is not ideal. We will show you how to create a button that allows a user to reassign multiple accounts in minutes. Let's go check out how to set this up. All right, here we are in Salesforce on the Accounts tab, and it would be so nice if we could just check the boxes on these records and then have a button right here that says Change Account Owner, where our users could change the owner of multiple accounts at once. Well, that's what we're going to implement right now. So our first step is to go back into Setup, and we're going to go to Flows, and we'll create a new flow. We'll start from scratch. This is going to be a screen flow. We're first going to add a screen element, and this is going to allow the user to choose the new account owner. I'm going to add a lookup field, and this is going to be a lookup to the user. The APM name is going to be owner ID. The label will be choose new account owner. And then the object is from the account. Now this is required, so I'm going to put true in here. Then I'm going to make this a little bit prettier by adding a section. And what this will do is it's going to open up into full screen and it'll make it show in the middle of the screen. So it just looks a little bit nicer. Next, I'm going to add an update records element. And this is going to update the account owner on all of the selected account records from the list view. And this is going to search for all of the accounts with ID in a variable that we're going to create. This variable is going to be called IDs. It has to be called IDs. This is a standard Salesforce thing. Any ID that a user selects in a list view is automatically passed to a variable called IDs, and this is how we can get the IDs that the user selected. So you'll need to make sure that the name is exactly the same as that. It's a text collection, it allows multiple values, and you have to make it available for input. Make sure you have all those three things configured. So we're going to look for the account ID to be in our variable called IDs. And then if it is, we're going to run an update to the owner ID to be the value that the user selected in the screen. We're going to click save here and we'll go ahead and name our flow so we don't lose any of our changes. Going to name this account update owner from list view. And then we'll give it a good description. This flow is invoked from a list view button and it will allow the user to update the account owners of multiple records at once. Now we have one error up here that we need to resolve. We are missing navigation from that screen, so let's go check that out. I accidentally unchecked that one. All right, there we go. Our next step is to add a success screen. And I'm going to add a display text here. General rules, I always use a 16-point font so it's nice and legible for all users. And then we're going to say here, accounts were reassigned to, and then we'll get the new account owner name here. And I just have to name the screen. Okay, we'll save that. Now, one thing that we saw happening during testing is whenever a user would use this button, the screen flow just keeps routing through this same screen and it doesn't take the user back to the related list that they started from. So this is really important for us to make sure that we can get the user out of the screen flow without having to click elsewhere in the org. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't figure out a way to pass the value of the current related list that the user is on. I could only figure out how to create a way to get the user back to the recently viewed list on the accounts tab. So that's what we're gonna show you here right now. Now, some of you might be saying, why don't you use Navigate Anywhere? Because this is a screen flow that's invoked from a custom button and Navigate Everywhere doesn't support that functionality. But what we did find is another Salesforce person called Yumi from Salesforce Time. We'll put his link to the article that we found. He gave us instructions on how we can control target behavior of links in a flow using formula fields. So it's a brilliant no-code solution. Thank you so much for sharing that. And we'll show you how to do that right here. So we need to create two different formulas. So we'll come over here to our resources and we'll create our first formula. This is going to be called For Account Tab Link. This is going to be a text, and then this is the formula. So we'll paste this in the description below for you. But basically what this is doing is this is finding the URL based on your org. Whether you're in production or sandbox, it's automatically gonna find your org's URL. So for us, it's going to find everything up until theforce.com and automatically put it into this formula. So this means you don't have to make any changes when you deploy from sandbox to production for this. Now, the second part of this formula is routing the user to the recently viewed list view on the accounts tab. We'll click done there. Select another new resource. This is going to be a text template and our name is TT account tab link. And then there's a little trick here. You have to make sure that you say view as plain text right there. And then we're going to put this into the body. We'll make sure to provide this in the description below as well. And then we'll click done there. Then we can put this link at the bottom of our success screen. All right, we'll save and activate. And now we're ready to test this out. All right, we need to create a button on the account object. So we'll come over to our object manager. We'll go to the account. Go to Buttons, Links, and Actions. We'll click New Button or Link. The name of the button will be Change Owner. We'll give this button a description so we make sure we know what it's doing. This is going to be a list button and you wanna make sure that display checkboxes is set to true. And the URL for the button is going to be our flow URL. You will find that by coming here to the main page of your flow. And you'll copy and paste this URL right here. Click save there. Next, we need to make this available to our users from the list view. So we're going to go to list view button layout. You'll click edit. You should see the change owner account button here in your custom buttons and we'll click save there. So now we'll come over to our accounts tab and we'll refresh. And we should see our change account owner button right here, which we do. Now we can go to any list view and we can check the boxes next to our accounts to change the owners. So if we go to all accounts, I have a list of all my owners over here so I can see if they change or not. So I will select these first 7 and I'm gonna change these from me over to Blue Tiger Academy. So let's go ahead and click our change owner button. And I'll search for Blue Tiger Academy. I'll click next. And then it says that that was successful. So I'll return to the accounts tab. And then we can see that those 7 should have been just modified from me to Blue Tiger Academy. And we do. So now if we wanted to change all of these, so I've got 58 accounts in here. I want to change them again to me. And I'll go back to the all accounts and I can see they were all changed to me. Now, one thing I want to point out is that the related records are not being updated here. So whenever you're using this change owner account button, you know, you have the functionality of whether or not you can update related records. And there are certain records that are just automatically reassigned to the owner. Sometimes you want this and sometimes you don't. When you use this change account owner button, you don't have a choice. These are automatically reassigned. When we are using our custom change owner button, no related records are reassigned from the old owner to the new owner. So that is something to keep in mind. We are going to show you how to do this in a future video though. So wait for that one. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on our next video that will show you how to add more features to this button. We will give users the ability to decide if they want to reassign contacts, open opportunities, and open activities over to the new account owner. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.